Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. This is the third video in the Reading Every Book by Lynn Painter series, and this time we will be reading Betting on You. I lost the book. Also, I cut my bangs and re-bleached my roots. Do we like it? Be honest with me. Also used the e.l.f. blush on my cheeks and it got a little too crazy, and I feel like I'm giving We Have Sabrina Carpenter at home, but it's fine. I feel kind of cute, you know? Sabrina was doing something right because my self-esteem right now, through the roof. Good song by Chase and the Antics. Also, Billie came out with her new album. The album is so good, like... That's my favorite part. Anyways, I will now be showing clips of me reading, and then we will discuss my overall thoughts on it afterwards. I did, however, already start the book a little bit, so I am a bit of a fraud there. I am noticing that the pace of this book might be a little bit quicker and not like an enemies to lovers or like slow burn moment, and that's something that's making me a little nervous because I really don't want to dislike this book for that. So we are gonna hope and pray. We're just gonna read. See ya. I'm sorry this lighting sucks. I did end up getting sick, so the light hurts my eyes, but I'm listening to the audio version of Betting on You because I was getting a little frustrated with Charlie's beliefs, and it felt like he was kind of condoning cheating in some way, which felt really silly and goofy, and I'm really hoping that's not what he means by the time I finish the book. I'm on chapter 26, and we just got past the scene where they stop because Charlie loses the keys, and it does feel like he is showing signs of having OCD because I have just now realized he has been tracking how often people do things and counting, and it does feel very much like a trait, as well as the fact that he physically could not get himself to grab the keys because of where they were, and that's all. I'm just theorizing at this point he does have OCD. Let's see if I'm right. I'm back, I'm sorry. But the fact that there's only like 20 pages left and we have a lot of unresolved issues. I did it, guys. I finally pulled through and finished reading Betting on You. This one was truly the toughest book I've ever had to finish reading just because I don't think the main characters actually had any chemistry with each other. Like at all, like the entire time I was just like I did not care at all about them. Like Charlie and Bailey were giving me nothing, honestly. Like, I don't know, I feel like they went from immediately hating each other to immediately having feelings for each other. So there was like no build up. And then when it happened, you're like, okay, why don't you guys just express this? Like it's so clear. Like they made it feel so difficult as if they literally were not in love. I feel really bad talking so much negativity about this book, but unfortunately it did have a third act conflict and it did feel very unnecessary, and it did. These last like 20 pages were literally just solving every single issue that had ever been brought up in the book, and it felt so rushed, and like the closure just really wasn't there, if we're being honest. And even the issue with her parents felt like it genuinely could have been solved so easily. I did rate this book 3.5 out of 5, and I have some tabs of parts that I enjoyed. Nobody Knows by the Driver Era was included in this book, and that is an absolute banger, so that was really cool to see. That scene where he was like, you are gorgeous when you're kiss drunk, Mitchell, did you know that? That was so cute. I have it highlighted. I loved it. I ate that up. There's a lot of tabs of me just hating Charlie because he was really annoying. But yeah, I am excited to start the next Lynn Painter book, and hopefully it is a little bit better than this and catches my attention. Because Better Than the Movies genuinely was so good, and the do-over was also so fun, and I don't know why this book just didn't stick for me. But I will see you guys in the next one, where I hopefully adore the book I'm reading. Thank you for watching. Bye!